وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters, we need to remember that when we try and impress the world, we may lose our sanity, we may lose our happiness. We will never be satisfied because the world moves ahead and continues to progress, and we will have to live up to something new every day. And if we don't live up, we've lost out. So you might have been a very popular person because of something Allah blessed you with at a certain point, and a few days later, or a month or a year later, that thing may not be as popular anymore. So if your focus was to please human beings, you will never achieve that goal. Human beings will never be pleased with you long term. Maybe short term, yeah, they might be okay with you. But when you don't have what they want you to have, they no longer want to know you, subhanAllah, in most cases. But those who are genuine will always be with you, even if you're not trying to impress them. So just try to impress Allah. When you're impressing Allah, nothing can go wrong. Allah loves you, and He will make sure the right people love you. So if you're going to sit back and try and impress the whole world because you have something, or you've compromised your relationship with Allah, do you know that with social media right now, a lot of people would only achieve attention or gain that attention by transgressing the commands of Allah? That's a fact. A lot of people on social media have to do something that is considered religiously taboo in order to gain the attention of people. They lose the attention of Allah. SubhanAllah, think about it. So if you're gaining popularity for the right reasons, mashallah, good news to you. Wallahi, wallahi, it's so beautiful. But if you are gaining that attention with the wrong things, which is the majority, then we need to change that. Never mind if the people don't know you. For as long as the angels know, they take your deeds going up every day, and Allah knows, that's sufficient. For Allah alone to know is actually sufficient. And Allah knows your heart. He will give you the tranquility. I'd rather be known by a smaller number of people, my own family and a few friends, and perhaps a little circle of people, as a good person, reaching out to them and being able to prove myself as a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Allah as to what He wants from me, than to be known by so many people, but I'm not content, I'm not happy. So if you look at the popular people across the globe, you know, be they pop stars or singers or whatever else, in a lot of cases, they're not satisfied with themselves because they're running a race they can never, ever win. They will have to live up to a standard that's always going to be pushing the limits, breaking certain lines and barriers with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if that is the case, they can't achieve contentment. My brothers and sisters, your hope and your healing can only be achieved by your relationship with Allah. There's no other way. When you relate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have a lot of hope. And remember, the hope is not only for the healing of this particular world, but even for the hereafter. So if we move on to the verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says He's going to test you, and He's going to test you with a lot. Do you really think you're going to achieve paradise when Allah says, we haven't yet tested you like we tested those before you? This is verse number 214 of Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah says, they were afflicted by war, by hardship, by difficulty. They were shaken until the messengers from amongst them said, when is the help of Allah going to come? Now the verse of hope. Ala inna nasrallahi qareeb. Indeed, the help of Allah is very near. SubhanAllah. We're going through a great pandemic on earth at the moment. In these times, it's an historic moment, because people will be speaking about it in the next generations. However, Allah says, you don't know when it's going to end. What we know, ala inna nasrallahi qareeb. Behold, the help of Allah is very near. Have hope in Allah. Your days will be better. The days will be good. And you will come out of this. And the tough days will be changed by good and easy days by the help of Allah So don't despair, because the help of Allah is very near. And if you look at the verses, verse number 216, for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us how sometimes you dislike something, but it's better for you. Wow, in that verse, there's a lot of healing for me. And there's a lot of hope, because there are so many things in my life that did not work out. I think I've gotten to where I am today because of certain things not working out. And do you know that nearly every one of us, in fact, every single one of us, we've achieved a lot because our plan didn't go exactly as we planned. Allah closed certain doors. That's why we are where we are today. Had Allah opened all the doors we wanted opened from day one, perhaps we would not have achieved as much as we have right now. We would have been sitting in our comfort zones and it wouldn't have been so good. But Allah closes doors in order to open other bigger doors, if only you understood. Allah lets you go through divorce, lets you go through loss of a job, loss of sustenance, loss of lives, health problems, whatever else it may be, in order to open doors that are humongous compared to what you had. You need to be patient. If you're not going to realize those doors in this world, you will definitely see them in the hereafter. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, at times you dislike something, but it's better for you. That's why we put you through it. So take it in your stride. Allah says, Wallahu ya'lamu wa antum la ta'lamun. Allah knows. You are the ones who don't know. Allah knows the future and what it holds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides us. And this is why the verses of divorce follow this, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, we have a lot of hope when it comes to marriages that are not working. What is this hope? The hope is, firstly, you need to try and make amends. Both parties need to try and make it work. Remember, marriage is a big sacrifice, very big sacrifice. You need to try and make it work. And secondly, what you need to know is, we call the parties on both sides to try and be fair and solve the matter. Alhamdulillah, Allah says, don't just break your marriage, try to make it work. If the two of you cannot, involve your folks. Subhanallah, it will heal. I've known of many cases where parents got involved or elders got involved and they solved the matter. But that's if both parties want to solve the matter. Don't just break a marriage. You have no guarantee that you're going to go into something better unless it is really unbearable or a terrible situation. Then, subhanallah, part of the hope is that Allah's given me the door of divorce. I can get out of this. Imagine being doomed for the rest of your life with someone whom you really don't get along with. That would have been very disastrous. So Allah says, divorce itself is a door of hope for the people as a last resort, but only as a last resort. So initially you try to resolve, then your folks or the elders, and thereafter, if one divorce goes through, Allah says that separation time, you can still get back to each other if you did it correctly. If you only issued one talaq or one divorce, then you can still get back together during that time, you know, the waiting time, as they call it, the iddah. And who offers you that? I mean, I divorced you, but I'm just getting back to you because you know what? I miss you and you were really a good person. Subhanallah. There's hope. There's healing in that. Subhanallah. And when we divorce, we're taught not to say bad things about each other. Just say, look, we were two good people who didn't get along. We were different. If you want to heal, don't say nasty things about each other. Don't try to prove who was right and wrong. The world is making a mistake by trying to teach you to prove your innocence when you know the marriage is over, it's gone. You know, let me not say nasty things. Look, the two of us didn't get along. We had our issues and we couldn't resolve them. That's it. We're done. The minute you get into bigger details, it delays your healing. And that's the problem. The quicker you get out of it, the quicker you heal. And so, subhanallah, if you want to get back, you may. If another divorce happens and you want to get back a second time, you may. The third time, Allah says, no. You've tried 2-3 times with this guy. It's not getting along. We want you not to go back to him. You must go and marry someone else. And when you marry this other person, then maybe perhaps you might then feel that this first person was better. If you go through a divorce with that second person, we allow you the window of hope to say, go back to the first one if you want now. Imagine what kind of mercy that is from Allah. Look at the hope that Allah's given us to say, you know what? I made a mistake. I can correct it. Allah says, we will always give you a chance to correct your errors. This is why, my brothers and sisters, learn about divorce. Many people divorce their spouses in a wrong way, and then they come and ask questions and they don't know what they did, and it creates a lot of issues. In order to avoid that, let's educate ourselves. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله
وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين